Good morning from the inside. I thought I would share with you what we have to fit inside my car. So I'm gonna go through this stuff in detail more than I normally would just for insurance reasons. So obviously you can fast forward through this, but I'm gonna do this just so I remember, especially when I come back, what's in what.
Linens, pillows, duvet cover, sheets, pillowcases, decorative stuff, electric candles, twinkly lights, gorgeous wine glasses, yoga kind of pants, tanks, calling it yoga wear, but didn't take yoga. Bike rear cargo rack, the bags, cargo cages, 3 bike saddles, boots, heavier shoes, sneakers, nicer shoes, all my camping stuff, cook stove, tents, headlamps, water purifiers, snowshoes, all pants, inflatable kayak, backpack, paddles. Mr. Puppy Dog.
He's gonna be guarding my unit when you open the door if anyone breaks in.
Inflatable like mattress, 6-person tent, heavy winter stuff, ski jacket, hats, goggles, baseball hats, and spare purses, kitchen stuff. When I rent these rooms that lift the bed off of the ground because a lot of times they don't have enough storage. These are awesome. I think I got them on Amazon. The wheel of the bed frame goes into that. Office, books, extension cords in there, really nice pens, clothes, sweaters, no pants are in here. Bathroom, road biking clothes, coats, down, comforter. Pillow, 2 throw blankets, 2 sleeping bags, 2 beautiful down pillows. I'm in the room a lot when you rent these rooms. I sit up on the bed a lot. 2 of the pillows are prop pillows in a sense, and then there's 2 sleeping styles. Nicer stuff, dresses, car cover, tarp that I'll put on the ground of the storage unit. But what we still need to fit, my luggage. Yep. So this one is maxed at 50, and this one is at 60 now. Everywhere I read it was 50, 50, 50, and now it's showing 70. And I added some almonds, believe it or not. That's my carry-on. It's a backpack duffel. I love it. It's a Patagonia. This is supposed to only be 15 pounds. This is my purse, and there's no weight on your purse. That's padded, and so my laptop's in there, and then I have my iPad in here. One guy said when he flew on Qatar that they actually did weigh it. When I've flown around the US, no one ever weighs my carry-on. So I thought, well, if this goes over, I can put it in my purse. And it sucks, because my ankle is still kind of black and blue. That's on the inside, it's healing. And then the outside just has a, see the mark there? And still swollen. Are you ready to see what we're gonna fit this in? Yep. I couldn't do it without this big sack up here. There's my bike, and these are what my car is gonna drive on. I had the guy cut them at Lowe's. I realized that the width isn't the width of the tires they're to drive on. So I actually still have to cut them in the center. Oh boy, trying to figure out the car. So I don't think I'm gonna put the seats flat, because I don't know if they should be in that position for that long. I feel like it's gonna do something weird with the faux leather and the way the seat belts hit. How are we gonna fit this into that? There's nothing really that I can go without. I mean, I only have like 7 pairs of socks. It has to fit. I don't have an option. There's all stuff that I need to take. I wouldn't leave any of this behind. I mean, the only thing I could leave behind is my rock. I love my rocks. See it? Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, look at all the pink. It's this one. Ta-da! If I had more stuff, we would have made it work. And if I had less stuff, it would have fit just as tight. Because now it's like, how is it always just exact? I was able to get my styrofoam in and Mr. Doggy. We're only going 2 hours and then I'll unpack it, so it's not that big of a deal. Oh my gosh, that was a whole project strapping that on by myself. We are all done. Love these old school dressers. And this is what I'm leaving her. 2 books, caramel, because she loves caramel. And then replacing the little candle. Traveled with a couple of these self-flickering candles. They're quite beautiful. I thought I don't need 3 in my room. I'll leave one for Elaine. Put it on a timer so it turns on like right before she comes home from work. And when I first moved in, she did mention that it's been really nice having it. And now I'm taking it because, I mean, they're kind of expensive, but I think it would be a great gift to surprise her and just get her just a cheaper version. My big robe, cords, and shoes. In fact, I'm leaving her these. She actually has the same size foot. Bye, awesome room. I left this for Elaine for when she opens the refrigerator. Oh, happy that I'm gone. She has her house back and her 2 shelves. And we're off. I won't miss those people. Right now it's amazingly quiet in their front yard, but it's just usually nonstop trucks. Bye, St. George. There's the famous Dixie Rock. It's a big tourist stop. At the bottom of this hill is where, like, that's the downtown in regards to where there's people. There's the popular pizza place, Thai place, like burger beer joint, hair salon, the Cafe Feel Love, and this cool dragon sculpture. Yeah, he's pretty awesome. This is the spot where on the right, I was just saying the cafe, the pizza, the Thai. And then when you come right here, this intersection, where all those cars are parked, that's it. And then I'll show you on the left, there's just this few shops right here. I like old towns, it's just this one, there's no user-friendly area. And this strip is nice, but nobody really walks on it. It's not a strolling street. And this donut place just went in. This is a lot of Mormons here, and there's a lot of kids, so there's all kinds of Slurpee drive-throughs, donuts, cookies. Oh, I was gonna get a crumble cookie. I think that area is called Bloomington. It has some amazing trails up in those mountains. It has tons of trees. Like, this would be a really nice neighborhood to live in. There's Mormons everywhere, but I think this is a really stronger concentration. And just the stories I hear about if you're not, and neighbors, and I mean, I've had great experiences, but you know, I'm just renting rooms in people's homes. It's really lush. That's why I really like it. It has a sense of community and neighborhood, unlike the northern part of St. George, which is very barren. I mean, yes, I realize it's a desert. Anyway, on our way to Vegas, baby! And I will be getting a lottery ticket because it's at $1.9 billion. You know what's crazy that I just realized? Initially, I wasn't getting a unit. I was keeping everything in my car while I was gone for those 8 to 9 months. My car would have been this packed all that time. And in regards to getting flat spots, my car won't have so much weight sitting on the tires. So now at least that's another benefit of getting the unit. I mean, there's so many benefits, right?
I've seen a lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay. I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago.
Goodbye, a lottery ticket, and then I saw
I've changed this. For the better this time.
Oh, I got you.
I thought I would never be fine.
When I win, this place gets a portion of the profits, so it'd be so nice to have this little tiny joint get the money versus Maverick or Pilot.
Way back a year ago.
See Vegas in the distance? Wow! That little pocket of casinos, this really gives you the feeling of what it was like before they built it. Just sitting there like that in the middle of this desert, and it's amazing the billions that pass through it. We're in northern Vegas, which gives me the skeevy jeevies. Some car was behind me, and you're going slow, and you know, oh, there's an out-of-state plate. I remember in LA, I would get solicited, "Hi, are you lost?" Trying to recruit, they just follow if your plates are out of state, that you're maybe a bit naive. I'm trying to find cheaper gas. Seriously, why am I not surprised? Somebody stole the thing. So now I need to find a place with air. All right, we have air. You're supposed to put in 50 when you store your car. I just want to cut my styrofoam. These are my choices. This is gonna be a project because this is just the wind slow and gentle right now. I couldn't do it. I only had like a foot of it out and it was already just getting picked up by the wind. I'm not gonna be able to do it. So I'm gonna just go into the storage and you know, maybe I can cut it inside my unit. A lot of the storages in Vegas have horrible reviews of break-ins, a lot of car batteries being stolen. Here I am checking in. He asked me my last name, Stock, and he goes, "Really?
And I go, why? And he says,
my last name is Stock too.
I don't think I've ever met anyone with the same last name.
We're from Ireland.
Okay, that just severed us. Because I'm German.
I've actually looked it up on our system a few times and I haven't really been able to pull
to
much
find.
Out.
Yeah, cool. Cool. That's nice.
Yeah.
Ooh. I'm in the wrong building. It smells like food in here. I really thought because I was inside that this was gonna have a lock. The outside ones are almost feeling safer now because they're in front of the cameras. I mean, they don't even sweep. You know, it's one thing when these places are old. I get it, it's a cheap rate. It's the dirt. And if someone isn't taking pride in the establishment to clean it, what does that say about how they're gonna take care of your stuff? So here's the 5x5. I can go up. And the floor is super dirty. There's even a couple little things of mice poo. I think I'll take some peppermint oil and go around the rim. I'm trying to hide the bicycle against the back wall. Shoot, I forgot to put the freaking peppermint around the border because of the mice poop. But at least it doesn't get too cold here where it's like winter where they need to make nests inside. So hopefully I'll be okay. All right, here's video before I close the door. Meaning like if anybody enters or moves anything, I'll know. I actually had this in the unit for me, but when I told the guy I had this other one, he said, oh, does it have the black key? And I said, yes, and he goes, those are actually better. So that's what I'm using. Take this off. Well, the unit is cleaned to extra clean standards. It was disgusting. You wanna see how dirty it was? Yeah, it was amazing how clean it was.
So I'm actually pulling my car more forward so some cameras can catch anyone who's maybe trying to pop the hood of my car to steal my battery, since that seems to be the thing. There is the circular cameras there. When I leave, I'm gonna go in the office and see if those are even working. I'm gonna say, well, let me see, because where's the security? You know, the pitch on the website is, oh my gosh, it's amazing. So here's the fence people would have to come over. This one is down peppermint oil. Do this and lay them around by the drivers and passenger seat area, because the mice and stuff come in. You know, I know this is gonna dry up and stuff, but at least it will be something. Blessing my car. You always do the negative first, and then I'll undo the positive. It's super hot right now. And that will just help the battery not being drained at all. And it's making it easier when a thief comes in and wants to steal it.
But before you undo the battery, make sure you get your car on top of the styrofoam first.
Works for me. Did not leave any of the windows cracked just a tad. I was gonna, but I changed my mind.
Any damage in case anyone like hits me or something, I can show that here's what it looked like when I left it. Flawless, beautifully waxed. Windshields are perfect. Everything's perfect on this car.
I can't get this one off. Keep trying and trying and I can't get it. I'm starting to think you were supposed to do the positive first and not the negative. But anyway, I got one off. I think that's enough. And now I have to figure out where to put this because my car is... Oh, fuck. Did I not lock my car? Oh, no. Wait a minute. I think I can just... I don't need my key. It's so funny. I'm so trained with the key. I can just do the lock here. Oh, fuck. No, I can't. Oh, shit. So that's how I'm leaving it. We'll know if anyone touches it. I was just noticing the shape all the other cars were in. Everyone's gonna think there's something super fancy under that one. My gosh, I can't wait to get out of here. All right, we are done. Time to call an Uber.
I like alarmed my car, but the battery's disconnected, so it doesn't matter. Oh, do you know what I first did, which I didn't tell you guys, when I first arrived at the 5x5? I put my suitcase in the storage unit. My big green suitcase. How out of it, like how maybe stressed I was, and I was so focused on how filthy it was and just how the neighborhood is. Anyway, luckily I didn't pack my whole storage. And then could you imagine? I'm like, oh shit, the suitcase is in there. I am in my Uber, I'm finally leaving.
What? Yeah. In 400.
I'm only giving Michael Cheap to both of y'all. I don't got a bunch of other snacks.
I have to remember these other snacks. I like that.
I came to lay out the whole full course meal. I'm the one that's gonna do the lap dance and the pole dance. I don't know how, but girl, there is a way.
It's okay, you there's know? Intention.
There's a will, there's a way.
That's right.
If you're looking for something to come out of a whole bunch of women, I know how to wrap it up. Because I know how to be what I need to be for either one of y'all, because I've observed. I paid attention. Most people nowadays, they're just trying to see what they can get. I don't come to them looking for nothing from you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Now, if you give it or we give to each other, that's a different story. Amen. But I don't need you because you got a good job. Who cares? Just like you buy food for me, guess what? I buy food for you. I make my own money. I don't need yours.
This is so surreal. It's like, I knew I was coming to Vegas, but it's just hitting me now that I'm standing in this hotel in this casino. Oh my God, all the color and lights. I love it. My driver was awesome. People always tell me really personal things right away. And this is short drive. And she was telling me all kinds of stuff. Here's the room. It's very nice. Nice decor. Doesn't have any scent to it at all, which is great considering all the things that happen here. Like a whole wooden dresser. And then the shower, which I thought was interesting. It's sort of a handicap style. I wonder if they don't do tubs in a lot of the Vegas places. Concerned about people drowning if they're drunk or on drugs. I would normally sleep here, but I feel like everyone does that. I should sleep near the window. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I want to go walk around. Let's go walk around. I got to charge my phone first. Do you hear that? The restaurant is singing? It's a praying mantis. So this is actually looking east, south, where all the big fancy hotels are. It's Fremont. We're gonna go walk, and this is the old, I believe, like original Vegas Strip. I got a fun card, $5 play a game, I guess? This is blackjack. What if I don't wanna play blackjack? $5 dining certificate and a free beer or wine. Oh gosh. I don't know. Whenever you see all you can eat, usually means they just give you barely any fish and a ton of rice. I remember my 20s in New York City as I used to put the rice in a napkin on my lap and then go to the bathroom and throw it out. It was like $33, which makes sense. Anyway, this is the other place. So this is part of the coupon, but you see. Oh, it's really busy. Let's see what the prices are. It's a fig burger, bacon, fig, goat cheese. And I'm talking to these two awesome gentlemen. I got a peanut butter beer.
We're pimping her out. We gotta get paid
royalties.
I'm hanging with my new buddies. I had a few at the bar, but I chose these two because they were the most entertaining. Not to mention they both talk about their wives, which is a great thing. Oh my gosh, this is crazy. I've never seen this.
Just walking through the ceiling. Woo!
Get in, but this is what he was showing me, but that white sign's in the way. So see the fish tank? There's a tube in the center of it because there's a slide. You get to go through the fish. That is so cool. Look at the pool. You can swim right up to the glass. It's awesome.
We just met her tonight. She's a beautiful lady.
No, she is. You know what? She's going to Thailand. She got me worried. She's my new friend now. I'm worried about her. I'm like, you're going to Thailand.
You guys.
That's why we brought her. Come
on. You see, I'm like, you're going where?
The Hand of Faith Nugget, the world's largest golden nugget. The world's, not the United States. Wow. It's the largest on public display. It's 61 pounds, 11 ounces. But it's not letting us know how much it could be worth. A man who has chosen to remain anonymous, his wife and four young children were prospecting behind their modest trailer home when they made this spectacular find. So we're inside the Golden Nugget. Woo! What do you do when you're in Las Vegas? You look yourself up on the big TV screen, because I edit and everything and watch off of my laptop or my cell phone. So this is so bizarre. I'll be curious to see how the footage looks on a big screen, especially comparing maybe the 4K to last year's footage. Ooh, I don't know if I like this. Looking at me in 4K, my teeth look like I'm on crack. It does, like when people smoke crack and they're teeth get all, or is it meth, and it gets all black? Oh, that's so weird.
Because I got a younger one and I got an older one. The older one has the wisdom. The younger one is so naive. And me and the older one, we always have good conversations. The younger one, he thrives off of arrogance and pride. He thinks he knows it all, but so wet behind the ears. Neither one of them wants to put 100% into commitment. You want to know that I'm there, but you don't want to put 100% into commitment.
If you had to choose one.
If I could make one man out of both of them, girl, I would do it. You know, that would be so great if I could just grab both of them and just make one man. And Ronald ended up having prostate cancer. During that whole process, girl, I watched Ronald in diapers the whole time. It went from working to not working to him peeing on himself.
How is he now?
He's doing good.
He was lucky to have you in his life.
Girl, let me tell you something. I know that's why he won't let me go.
Well, a lot of people run away when that stuff comes, and you didn't. You hung in there.
Girl, and that's what happened. He thought that everybody would be, girl, they wasn't here for him. I know who I am, but everything that takes place outside of who God is teaching me to be, right?
Right.
That's what my awareness. And what I'm aware of, you can't dictate how I respond. Now, I've allowed some things to dictate my response. Why? Because I took my emotional stability and attached it to their chaos. So it left me in balance. You know what I mean? So I'm like, okay, hold on, bro. Reel it back in. You know what I mean?